hear and the noise you hear is simply the divine itself, and that there is nothing to be frightened of, and that you can totally and absolutely let go and surrender yourself in this moment. That veneer that lies on some of us, we can let it slide down right now. For we are divinely protected. And what I want you to do now is I just want you to breathe. And on your next breath, what I would like you to do is I would like you to begin in your mind's eye to see yourself rising. And as you rise, what I want you to do is turn 180 degrees from any concept of fear or any concept of impossibility that might enter your mind. I want you to imagine, as you turn the 180 degrees, that laying before you is a blank slate, infinite in dimension. It goes forever, north, south, east, and west. It is clean. And I would have you put a dot in the middle of it. And then as you breathe, move closer to that dot. I want you to see that dot as the culmination of our vision, the manifestation of a world that works for everyone. And I want you to imagine what that would look like for you and what that would feel like for you. And every time that doubt steps forward and nibbles, just bless it, love it, and allow yourself to move to the next stage that is required. I want you to feel what it would be to live in a world where there was enough water, enough food, where there was no violence. Live in a world where people shared openly and joyously, where there was easy accessibility to technology, to medical care, the education for all. Where the color of your skin, the religious denomination you belong to, or your sexual preference didn't matter. I want you to imagine what it would be like to feel so good about yourself that you did not need to defend, and you did not need to withhold. That you simply acted as that participant in the mosaic of life that you were born to be, the authentic self, the actualized self, that is a divine reflection of spirit itself. Part of a mosaic that works in harmony with all. I want you to feel this to the very best of your ability. And when you can feel it, what I would have you do, even if you just can brush it, is I would have you nod your head. That feeling that you have is real. That feeling that you have is the idea. Everything else is engineering. So, we'll treat together, supporting each other in our ideal and our knowing. Believing that there is God in absolutely nothing else, and recognizing without question that we are unified with it, as is all things. That the entire body of the universe is the universe itself, in perfection and light and life and love. Knowing this, we simply speak our word, knowing that the intention that we put before us must become the reality of our experience when we surrender to this power that is who we are. I therefore lay out here right now that feeling that you have, that feeling of a world that works for all, and I lay it before myself knowing that it must become a reality, that no experience can transform it and change it, that everything that is required must be given unto it, and everything that is not needed must be dissolved and dissipated now. I lay this before me with an understanding and an appreciation that every single activity in my life brings me closer to it. I speak my word knowing that there is no need to do anything other than move in the direction of my life, for from this moment forward, it has been divinely changed at depth. For there has been an idea that has been supplanted and implanted into my mind right here and right now that is greater than any idea that I've ever had before. And that idea draws, attracts, and pulls each and every one of us towards it. And that every experience that occurs is the experience of our adopting, embracing, and being the vision that we want to be. And who we want to be. I accept that this is already complete, that it is already done. I accept from this moment forward that every time that I move in a direction that somehow either points me towards something that I do not want to have created, I instead move my energy back to an understanding and an appreciation that my life is dedicated to creating a world that works for all, that is laid before me, and it must become a reality. I am grateful that this is so right here and right now, and joyously, with an unconditional gratitude, I surrender this back to that universal mind, which is all mind, your mind, my mind, and the mind of life itself. And I let it be my truth, and I live from it with expectation and anticipation. I let go, and I let God, and so it is.
So it is.